An undeniable truth that can't be ignored is the blatant push for all things sexual. From beer commercials to sports cars to perfumes, sex sells. 47% of American households say that internet pornography is a problem in their house. And that's no surprise, with 4.2 million pornographic websites vying for our attention. Whether you're checking in the news headlines or reading about politics, sex and sexuality always seems to be in the headlines. But our sexuality has been broken and manipulated in such a way that it's caustic to the soul. Trafficking of human beings for the sex trade has skyrocketed worldwide. And right here, in our own backyard, in a recent sting operation, 33 people were arrested or ticketed for their connection to prostitution or the sex trade. The profit motive is causing a massive amount of abuse and manipulation and even the slavery of human beings. Pornography itself is the driver behind both the felt need for this trafficking and the economic engine that's behind it. As the church, we're God's hands and feet to bring about justice for those who have been oppressed. We can't stand idly by any longer and allow human trafficking to continue. But as the people of God, we must stand up for those who have been victims of this horrific abuse. We'll be diving into a message series to expose the dirty laundry of our culture. Our dream is to educate and equip the church to be on God's side of justice. Our hope is to stand up for those who have been the victims of abuse. Our passion is to educate parents on the dangers that lurk for their children in their homes, on their computers, and in their cell phones. The third week of our series will include an expert on the subject, a special guest speaker from XXXChurch.com. Our guest will speak frankly about a subject that has been taboo in the church. Their emphasis is reaching lost people in the porn industry and helping people deal with the prevailing issue of pornography with compassion and hope. So set aside these three Sundays with great anticipation and bring a friend. It will change our church, and I hope it will change our city.